Hello YouTube. I'm doing a video with the spawn of Icy Mike's. Like he had a live video, and I comment on the red comment and says I don't fully agree on a taller person versus smaller person. I'm 5'7". I guess a bigger person. No, no, it was like he's tall, he's about 60 pounds, I'm short. If somebody's taller than me, versus somebody, okay. Let's look at, if it's in a street fight, there's no weight class, there's no, there's no rules, okay? And the first UFC, right, they didn't have almost no rules in that. And it's been proven a few times where a smaller fighter beaten a bigger fighter, okay? So There's a lot of people in this world can. Maybe I'm taking this out of content of when he talked about a smaller guy is versus cannot beat a bigger guy. Maybe I'm taking it out of context. But what I'm saying is, like, in a street fight, you have no way of defending yourself fully. You just have to go out there and hope for the best in the sense of, like, use your tools and your knowledge. Use your brain, because that's your biggest weapon you got in here. Use your brain to help you defend yourself against somebody who's going to be bigger. Skill level, you don't know. One person told me that before the movie came out, Juno, and he used it as a acronym. Just don't know. All right. I know Juno. You just don't know what I know. As that's the thing about a street fighter, you don't know the level, what level they're gonna be at when you fight them. That's why you gotta adapt to the level. And then watch. They throw a punch, and how they, if you watch the. Way they start off, and when they get into the ready position, right? The guard, if they have their hands up, and it's a good stance, then they have some training. So from where you don't know. If his hands down, he's doing this number. He's obviously has no training. If you have your hands up and you're ready to go, you may have a better solution. If you have a black belt, does not mean anything in a street fighting situation. Okay, doesn't mean nothing. Unless you know how to use what you learn and that art to adapt to in a street fight, okay? Then maybe that can mean something to it, okay? So you have to respect that person's way of fighting. Okay, so then he goes, oh, you agree, what I agree with was the competition fighting. I wasn't, the only thing is that I agree with you, Icy Mike, is that when it was bar as first barring, when you lose, and yes, it sucks, and I agree to what you said too, that it doesn't, nobody shouldn't feel bad about loss. You should embrace it and try to become better and for that, because granted, you're not going to win every fight and when you compete. However, in my opinion, you can have a choice to do your best, even though you may get your ass kicked and that in a street fight. You don't have the knowledge of what this person has. You don't. That's a big difference between a street fight and a competition fight, right? You can, especially if you have if you can watch the last person's fight on that. Prime and simple. If I was going to train for the UFC, right? If I was going to train for the UFC, for instance, if I was like Chuck Liddell or Randy Orton, I'm not Randy Orton, but Chuck Liddell, let's see if Anderson Silva. Sylvia, whomever, right? If I knew the person who I'm gonna fight, I would study. I would always be studying the way he moves. What if I can I spot his weaknesses? All that, so you can go back to the old fights that person had and use that to your advantage. And then from that to and you train accordingly. Also knowing that you learn about your opponent, whether or not he's a stand up fighter, he moves. He likes to explore. He's always trying to keep it to on his feet. He also likes to he likes to clinch. Or if he gets a lower thing, maybe can watch when he's ready to shoot and take go for a takedown. That's, you know, a big difference between street fight. You can have the same concept, right? If only thing is, you can't watch that person's fights before his previous fight. But what you can do is watch the different position. Of this person's thing. Maybe if he goes lower in his stance, he's possibly wanting to go to the ground. Okay? If his hands are low, he's definitely a street fighter. He might have one hand low and one hand to the midsection. That's more of your common street fight hand position, they're always gonna be lower. They're gonna be right here or here. If you're a Jigendo guy, your hands are like this. If you're a Wing Chun guy, this. If you're a Karate guy, you have your chin right over here, and this. So if your hands are low, real low. And so you also to kind of tell what the hand what kind of training they may have, depends where the hands are at. Okay. Whether or not they have any training at all. And then also you can look at the way they punch. They punching like this, like they kind of swimming. I've seen like that before. If they are fighting like this, like they swimming, they have no, because I've seen, every of those playful fights, you can see like this, like that, just playing, even though they're just playing around, and they have that motion, and they have that thing, and while they're doing it, the hands go down, they come back, they go up, and the hands go back down. And I'll let you know when not to, or if they flinch when somebody comes back. They flinch back, and the hands up, they flinch back. They're flinching because they don't want to get hit, as if they hit with a plane fire, right? So, a lot of you tips, Icy Mike, I agree to a point, okay? For instance, like I said, I have a cut off call. Maybe I can explain more because I'm not a great texting. Sorry. I'm not great doing texting, especially when I am using a phone. So, I hope the point I was getting across is bigger and smaller opponents versus a small. Smaller fighter versus a big fighter. It's not a smaller fighter would not always lose against a bigger fighter. It's all about the skill level. Even if they have the same, it looks like they have the same speaking. If they have both same skill level, all right. This is at this point, if they have the same skill levels, right? At this point, now who can use a brain, and strategize, and make it work? So to say, or if that person's. So now in this case, if he's a big fella, he can move fast, he got quick hands, right? He can move quickly, he can go in and out pretty fast. He's able to move like a small person, and you're a small person, then that's when you have to strategize and come up with a game plan before the fight starts. My first, if I never met Isaac Mike, but we bump into the street and maybe he is having a bad day, or whatever. He got a chip on his shoulder. He's like. And one of those people was if somebody avoids his, as in bumps him, he's ready to knock somebody out. But, he accidentally picked a fighter who's bigger than he was. And he's saying, well, I know how to fight. And then now he's seeing the guy has his he's getting to a fighter stance too. And you have an option. Well, shit, he could be a damn good fighter. I said, hey man, I have a bad day, and walk away. You won. You just won. I said won. Nobody wins the fight. You walk away. He's like, well, okay. You just refuse to fight. He's like, okay. Or. You could go, still go over the guy, challenge yourself, so you see if you can fight and win the fight. Because, again, a street fight, you don't know the level of that person. So, yes, he might have his hands up and ready to go. But how well trained is he? You don't know. Just because he has his hands up, does not, how well can he deliver the techniques that he needs to fight you. Can he actually can move like a smaller person? How fast can he move? Now you see, since he is a bigger person, obviously he's gonna have a better reach. His reach might be 72 inches. That's a one-handed reach. Okay, and you may have just, I don't know, 62 inches. That's 10 inches difference. So you gotta find a way to get outside or inside of that person. To bridge the gap. It's okay. Fight. Now you're in fighting mode. You throw the jab here. Bam. Throw the jab again. Bam. He started to respond. If he flinches, that's when you know, okay, I got this. He's green. He's a green trainer. And I'm more experienced fighter. But if he got his up, he does a finish. He's moving around a lot good, better than most. Then you're like, okay, he knows how to fight. But let's see if I can switch it up. Then I go from this, then maybe I can go into that, then push off, and maybe his boxing is good, and maybe my grappling is better. So you can think about that. And so you don't know when he throws that jab here, maybe you jump down. You are able to get that grapple. He's probably in trouble. He might be an awesome boxer. You don't know the level of the person. Now if he's down more to a level, he's a grappler, possibly, right? So again, you look the change of that person's motion. Or not, you can possibly win the fight. You gotta be ready mentally and physically to and that. You have, but then again, it'd be on you. And if you just say, well, fuck it, man. I'll see if I can. Let me see if I test myself, and maybe I can get a knockout or a submission or something. To the man, or maybe he's better than I am, and I'll get beat up. I'll lose. So, but you can't have that. Shit! I lost. Let me just walk away. Let's say it was the other woman. You go. If you bump to him, he's like, "Motherfucker, what are you doing? You can't see me. I'm a big guy. Huh? What are you doing? Hey. Maybe he's like hey, what are you doing? Hey, what are you doing? You can't look at me. You can't see me. What are you doing? Dude, I just bumped in you. I don't care, little guy. I will mess you up. I don't know why he's doing this, but I'm gonna mess you up. Now, if he opens his up, and he's signaling you that he's gonna attack. Boop! That's a quick jab. Bam! Or, if he comes in, stop it because what are you doing to hit a neck? Yeah, I'm gonna hit a neck cap. I might not be able to break it, but it would get me an injury level. Boom! I threw a kick if a stop hit, followed up with a jab, right? Boom! I using my longest weapon to the nose target. It might overextend his leg, and if you have not overextend a joint, like your elbow, my special movie, or hit a bag, or maybe you're shadow boxing. If you overextend the kneecap, you could not always, if you have enough pressure and weight onto that kick, you possibly can break that guy's leg. But not 100% guaranteed, but as soon as you move that, boom, I'm able to hit maybe that jab's not gonna be my first personal thing. But if he comes in, I hit that step hit, I can come up with a cuffed, going to the air, and right into the air. Now I'm able to use my hand, other hand, probably going for a big out gouge. Maybe I can take this, go for the throat. What is it? Well, hit, boom, hit the throat. Then go hit it, and then I'm gonna grab for the hit, boom, headbutt, and the knee to the ground. Possibly punch him over, he could be really hurt. That's a possible scenario. How possible can that be? I'm not saying that could work. If you see it in your mind, visualize it, then it's okay. He's bigger than me. I gotta hit the vital areas. And then don't hesitate. Because you know that this is probably going to happen. He's ready to go. If he's doing this, if he's bucking up, or he's going this way, he's having mentality to attack. So you have to, as a smaller guy, you have to find a way to hit the vital areas on that person's body. If his face is not visible for you to hit, so you possibly get that knockout, Hopefully you can get to the legs, to the to make his Elvis stand that leg. And if you can somehow hit a very hard kidney shot, it's getting hit in the kidney shot sucks. It's gonna cause anybody pain. So if you get hit, he's doing this number. Now he got an opening to the neck or to whatever. Don't hesitate to boom. Go for the throat. Go for the eyes. Whatever. At quick do. Don't think about what it is you are wanting to do at that moment. Go for it. All right. I'm not trying. I'm not saying yeah. Hit the guy in the throat and try to kill it. No. Hit something where they cause some pain anywhere from the leg to up here to the midsection to cause them a lot of pain where they are they now they if they for the at least for them drop the shoot that dropped their guard and their hands is down so, and you hit, keep your hands up. Boom, maybe I'm able to go for the, take my hands up, open my hands up, go here, maybe, or court this here, boom, and I use that little technique, but bam, went into the throat, or what, you know, whatever weapons you try to use for that, maybe a quick, fingertips to the throat, bam. Bam, bam, sub hit to the leg. Maybe I hit the kidneys, and then go. I'm not aiming for the groin. I mean, unless I'm lucky, I get a nut shot. If I hit it right on the bun on the nuts, it's go. Quickly give him a pain. And I'm talking about a good crack to the balls. I'm not talking about a flick to the balls. I'm talking about a quick snap kick to the balls. So boom. But the idea is I'm just aiming for a foul area. That's the whole point. Aim to the fire area and then follow up. Whether it's a quick finger jab to the throat from and then come back with the air and then eye what up or to the nose. Whatever at that moment I'm flowing with. Right, so if I am able to hit a foul area, if I'm here, shoot, maybe this is my move. If I hit it in the throat, hit the ear, headbutt, then the knee to the groin area, right? That's a possibility. Okay, so. You have to look at, maybe my goal is to get a knockout, hit that sweet spot. I'm gonna do a hook to that sweet spot, but it looks like he's a good fighter that I thought he would be in the streets. So he got, cause he has his hands up. So now I gotta find other openings. Okay, that's just the way it is. Finding another opening to get what you need to win that fight. Does that make sense? Like I said, ask him, like, I'm not trying to down your... Maybe when you talk on him, please be more specific. why you think a smaller guy can't beat a bigger guy.
Make a video. To be honest, why do you think
before I go, you said there's not a martial arts, a self-defense made for small people. Wing Chun was defeated by a woman. Keep that in mind. Wing Chun was defeated by a woman. So there's a system that is made for smaller people. Because that's why, and when you learn Sun Tao, your hands is right here, to the breast. Like I said, Wing Chun was defeated by a woman. The whole process, I'm blocking my breast. Boom. That's why the whole tightness of this, boom, bam, right? I'm here, right? That's the whole idea behind Wing Chun. It's supposed to be self-touch is to deflect people with power. If I throw a powerful punch, I'm sweeping my hand out of the way by using a bonk style that way, a bonk style this way. So I am deflecting that person's power so I can go and to able to restrain. So now I'm thinking about one of the things you said, there's not martial arts that teaches small folks. Yes. Wing Chun was developed by a woman. She was small now. If you look at Bruce Lee, he was not that big. He's a small person. So it was developed. It was a system that was developed to help smaller people defend themselves, get bigger opponents. And it's a street fight martial arts. Street fight based martial arts. You really want to look into and into Wing Chun and really look in the history and how it was developed. Little lesson there for you guys. So, if you like what you saw, hit the thumbs up button, subscribe if you haven't subscribed. Thank you for watching. I'll see you on another video. Bye.